Here we go, the back kick. The holy grail of kicks. The one that everybody wants to get right. I'm going to break it down for you and show you exactly what you need to do and all the steps to build up to it. First, you can start on a table like this. You want to make sure your legs are straight. You are turning the foot. Your knees do need to be moving out wide. And the heels, try and keep them in line with your bum. They will rise, but if you try and keep the knee down and the heels to the bum as you turn the foot side onto the water, it will work. You need to reset the kick. So that's bringing the fin tips down, slowly back through the water, not pushing the water, twisting the foot and pulling. Very, very slowly, start position, twist, pull. It's all about having the correct tension in the foot pocket, pulling the toe towards the knee. It's not about how fast or how high your legs can rise. It's really about the tips of your fins, twisting them and pulling them in at the correct angle. When you practice this on the wall, be careful not to spend too long on the wall and just make sure you're going through the mechanics of the kick correctly. Try and keep those feet as low as you can. Always start from the starting position, which is the fin tips pointing down. Turn the feet out, widen the knees, and pull back the feet, holding the angle. If you find yourself wanting to speed the kick up, or you start looking down or looking back at your legs, you'll be breaking at the hip, and you will definitely be causing yourself problems. A good idea is to set a horizontal control line, ideally a little higher than shown here, and ideally you'll be looking at this line, and that will keep your head position up as you start to learn the back kick. Like these guys are doing here, and this is only their second day in Sidemount. You can learn this kick quite quickly. It's just important you understand the exact movements to make. So have a good tension body, looking ahead, straighten out the legs, fin tips down, twist the foot angle and pull the blades towards your butt. Try and keep your cylinders as streamlined as possible. Really take the time with your breathing control. Make sure when you're returning the kick to the start position with the fin tips down that you're not pushing any more water, causing you to go forwards. I'm going to take a look at this in slow motion. So bring the fin tips down, twist, pull. You can see the fin tips flexing as I twist the foot out. Knees go wide, heels are keeping low. And the majority of the kick is right at the start, keeping a good tension in the fin pocket. So you're pulling your toes towards your knees. You twist the ankle. So you're trying to put the blade more on its side. And you'll see then that actually grips the water and it pulls you backwards. You definitely need to keep tension in the hips and keep your hips level. You do this by looking up. And if your feet, you find them hard to move them down, there's a good chance you've lost the tension in the hips. Make sure you take lots of breaks while practicing this and only do it for 3 to 5 minutes at a time. This is the modified version of the back kick. And really, it's just like a backwards skull. You'll move back half as much and it's a great way to stabilize position while you're making an ascent. Here's it with the fins on, and you can see there's much less movement. It's really just about the ankles and the toes pulling towards the knee with a slight movement in the knee. You may find it easier to start learning this kick before you learn the full back kick. Again, do not rush it and keep it slow. Underwater, it should look like this. You can see there's not a lot of blade angle change. Keeping them down. Fin tips are staying just around my kneecap height. good tension in the hips, head position looking forwards. And I'm just using the very end of the fin tips to pull and flick that water, helping me move backwards. And you'll see I'm moving backwards only a fraction of the amount I was moving back with the full kick. This is a great kick to stabilize your position when you're learning advanced buoyancy control. You generally move the feet slightly faster than you would with the full back kick, and it's just a modified version. Once you get good at this kick, it's actually quite fun to try it with no fins, and you do have to move the feet a bit more violently, but it is possible to go backwards using no fins. It's actually quite good for discipline and the foot positioning. I do suggest you use a control line like I'm doing here. You can occasionally glance down at it, but you should always be looking forwards. The fins I'm using here are the Mares Quattro, and they're kind of neutrally buoyant in the water, ever so slightly negative. And they're a very supple fin. You can see the fin tips move very easily. I don't recommend split fins, and you'd find that this kick would be very inefficient using split fins. Now I'm showing you a more stiff fin. This is a jet fin, and you can see the difference here with the back kick. It's mainly the tips of the fins that you can see flexing, but the rest of the blade tends to be quite stiff. And you'll find that with jet fins, you generally get very good propulsion for this technique. You can get different types of jet fins, some more neutrally buoyant than others, and some very heavy. So it's just about choosing the right fin you would need. A fin choice is not just about how it feels on the foot, but also how it affects your diver trim. I show you that in my Sidemount skills videos. Now what you're watching is the back kick, but I'm playing it in reverse. So actually I'm moving forwards, but you can see the bubbles are coming down. The reason I'm showing you this is I want you to pay attention to how similar it looks to the frog kick when you're moving forwards. It's not exactly the same though. The ankle tension that you have is different, and it is harder to get the full range of motion that you can when kicking forwards. Just remember, with the back kick, it's a softer kick, and you do need to wait, and instead of gliding, you pause at the top of the kick, then you reset, pull, pause, put the foot back to the start position. If you rush it, if you speed this kick up, that's when you tend to have problems with it. I also have made another video showing all the problems and how you go about fixing them. Remember to relax between each kick. Practice this for 3 to 5 minutes at a time, and then make sure you rest and don't let yourself get too frustrated.